Hey, what up guys, we're back at it again with another awesome video for you today. There appears to be a bit of movement in the double homicide case that YNW Melly is currently in the process of dealing with. According to TMZ, the prosecutors in the case are making some moves that don't look good for Melly, including submitting a request for his DNA to potentially use as evidence against him. In today's video, we're finna be going over everything we know about the case so far and why prosecutors are requesting for Melly's DNA. But before we start, if you're a fan of the channel, you already know what it is.
Before we start the video, make sure to leave a like, and if you would like to join this month's giveaway of one of these items on the screen, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video to the end to comment the hidden keyword. Good luck!
Without any more hesitation, let's get into it. The incident occurred in the early hours on the morning of October 26. It was around 3 a.m. and four men, YNW Melly, YNW Sack Chaser, YNW Bortland, and YNW Juvie, had just finished up a session at the studio. The three had been chilling all day the previous day and had finally finished work, so it was time for them to head home. Bortland got in the driver's seat of the car. Melly was sitting beside him. Juvie and Sack Chaser were both on the passenger side of the car, front and back. And apparently, in an attempt to avoid early morning traffic, the group decided to take a back road home. Bortland was driving the car. The time was around 3:30 in the morning at this point. Now, at some point, the vehicle pulled over, and this is when things went down. There are two sides to this story as of right now. One was told by Melly, and one was told by prosecutors, who believe that Melly had actually been involved in the case himself. But we know for sure if after the vehicle pulled over and parked, bullets were fired. Neither Melly nor Bortland was hit in the barrage, but Juvie and Sack Chaser weren't as lucky. 40 minutes after the shooting occurred, the vehicle managed to make it to the hospital. But at this point, it was too late. Both men were pronounced dead. The way Melly tells it is that they had been victims in a drive-by shooting after another car pulled up on theirs. However, after investigating the vehicle, police claimed that the shots had to have been fired from the inside, right around where Melly had been sitting. And after gathering more evidence, they went on to claim that any damage done to the outside of their vehicle was caused intentionally by Melly and Bortland. And in February of 2019, YNW Melly was arrested for allegedly murdering two of his associates. In regard to the case against YNW Melly, he has yet to see his day in court to fight the charges, and that's what he's choosing to do. Despite what anyone is saying about Melly or whatever evidence they might have against him, Melly has claimed that he's not guilty of killing two of his YNW associates. But it's starting to look like the evidence being stacked against him might be too much for him to handle, especially with what the prosecution is currently trying to do. Things don't look good for him. TMZ was the first to report on it, but since then, many media outlets have mentioned the move that the prosecutors are making in order to help progress the case. According to TMZ, prosecutors submitted documents into the Broward County Court that were dated October 14th that requested that the judge, in the YNW Melly's case, require the rapper to submit to the taking of oral swab by a qualified technician. Now, we ain't talking about an oral drug test for a job or anything like that. Nah, the prosecutors want to get a hold of Melly's DNA, specifically his saliva. Though it doesn't really matter how they get his DNA, they just want to compare it to the other evidence that they have. The reason that they're requesting an oral swab is because unlike blood tests and other forms of DNA testing, oral swabs are considered to be one of the least intrusive methods. All it is typically a long Q-tip that is swabbed on the inside of the cheek or both cheeks and then immediately sealed in order to prevent any contamination. The prosecutors claim that their reason for requesting for Melly's DNA is simple. They found evidence inside of the vehicle that the alleged victims had been shot in, and there was a total of four different people's DNA on said evidence. The evidence was a yellow jacket that had been found at the scene, and one person's DNA was able to be identified as one of the alleged victims. However, the other three belonging to people unknown as of right now, and prosecutors think that one of those people might be Melly. The three unknown people are being referred to by prosecutors as potential contributors, meaning that the DNA most likely belonged to the person or persons involved in the shooting that left Sack Chaser and Juvie dead. As we said before, the DNA swab would involve no unruly intrusion on Melly's part, and if he's innocent like he says he is, then he shouldn't be too concerned. Therefore, the prosecutors have basically demanded that they be allowed to test his DNA in the interest of justice. And I wouldn't even think that they would have gone that far. You would think that because it's a murder case, DNA evidence should have already been submitted into CODIS, or the Combined DNA Index System. but I guess that isn't the case. And now there's an official request submitted into the Broward County Court for it. Meanwhile, as we said before, YNW Melly has remained adamant in the fact that he wasn't involved in the death of his two associates. He stands by his account of the incident, claiming that the group ended up being caught in a drive-by and that Melly was lucky to make it out alive. If the prosecution does manage to get their hands on Melly's DNA, it might be all over for him. When it comes to evidence, some hold more weight than others, and DNA is one of those forms of evidence. DNA is something that's very specific to each individual, and if it comes up as a match, it's very hard to dispute it. And according to prosecutors, they have a jacket that they believe contains Melly's DNA. That would not only place him at the scene, but it would also be a good way to argue that things went down a certain way. Now obviously, we don't have all the facts, but the prosecutors would not have asked for a sample of Melly's DNA if they didn't have any need for it. This means they likely have something solid, and should it end up being a match for Melly, he'll likely be facing the full extent of whatever his sentence ends up being. YNW Melly was arrested in February of 2019 for his alleged involvement in the death of his associates, YNW Sack Chaser and YNW Juvie. And when news of this broke out, fans were shocked, especially considering the fact that Melly claimed that the incident that occurred was a drive-by in which he was also a target that managed to get away. However, after investigators found a ton of evidence to contradict Melly's story and possibly even place him as the alleged shooter, he quickly became their prime suspect and was locked up. He's been sitting in jail waiting for his trial for over 2 years now, and just a few months shy of three. At first, many speculated that if he was found guilty, that Melly might end up getting the death sentence. However, as of right now, it seems like the prosecutors are trying to hit him with life in prison rather than death. Now, as we said multiple times, and as Melly says, he's fighting this case. He claims that he's not guilty of the heinous crimes that he's being accused of, and man, I hope it's true. You never know, but I hope it's true. The thought of someone could possibly just turn on two of his friends after spending hours together that same day and then opening fire while being right next to them is crazy. It's a scary thought for sure, and it makes YNW Melly look like a monster. If he's guilty, he's likely finna get whatever he deserves in terms of sentencing. However, if he's innocent like he says he is, hopefully he'll be able to clear his name of all this mess and stink that's surrounding it, cause you know how prosecutors be lying just to put people down. YNW Melly is currently in jail waiting his court date, and I'm sure he's more anxious about it than any of us. If the evidence that the prosecutors might have against him is as legit as they say and they manage to get a sample of his DNA, it might be all over for him though. But what you guys think? Will the courts decide that YNW Melly is required to submit an oral swab, or will they for some reason say it's unnecessary? Be sure to let us know in the comment section.
Hey you, yeah you, you like the video? Great, we got another one for you that we guarantee you'll like. And all you have to do is click on the screen. It's free and without any hidden fees, but you have to click on fast because this message will self-destruct in 5 seconds.